How to overcome fear of competition. I share how I overcame my fear of competition with my unique stamp it out process to reject disbelief. If you are letting competition stop you from achieving your full potential, you'll get so much benefit from this. Have you ever had a passion for helping people or sharing something with the world? Have you then looked at the competition and convinced yourself that you'll never be as good as someone else, so there's no point in even trying? Today I'm sharing my story about my battle with my fear of competition that consumed me for years. I finally let go of this fear after taking myself through my stamp it out process and rejected this disbelief. I'm sharing how I did this today so you can experience the same level of relief that I now have when it comes to competition and putting myself out there. Today you will discover why competition doesn't even exist, why more helpful ways of viewing competition exist, and my unique process for releasing fear of competition. My name is Kath Kyle and I'm the author of Stamp Goals book, and I'm so happy that you're here. I help content creators and change makers manifest business success through spirituality, self-belief and strategy, and I help you master your marketing, manifestation and money mindset. So let me ask you, do you have a fear of competition, or are your thoughts about competition holding you back from reaching your full potential? Let me know what you're struggling with by leaving a comment on my blog, YouTube channel or sending me a DM on Instagram. So here is a new healthy way to view competition. When I started addressing my attitude, I realized how unhealthy my viewpoint was. The results of living in constant fear and envy of competition will mean that you either fail to get started at all, or if you're already in a business, your business will start to go downhill. Fear and envy literally eats away at you and destroys any success you might have. It is natural to experience negative emotion and inevitable that these kind of feelings will arise, but it's vital that you resolve these issues and let them go. I'm going to show you how to do that in a minute, but first of all, I am going to share with you a much more healthy attitude towards competition. I have now got a completely different attitude towards competition, and I'm going to share that with you now. Here's what I now believe. Here's my belief number one. There is no such thing as competition, and this sounds a bit weird, but hear me out. After years of struggling with what I thought was a problem with competition and a fear of my competitors, I've now eliminated competition as a problem entirely. What I believe now is that if I have a desire and a passion to share something with the world, that desire has been placed on my heart for a reason, and it is not dependent on anything that anyone else is or isn't doing. I believe that competition doesn't really exist for the simple reason that there is always more people coming into this world, more babies being born who grow into adults, and they all have different preferences, needs, and methods of finding solutions to their problems. And just because you might feel like there are some really big brands dominating the market that you want to enter into doesn't mean that you are also not going to get success. Everybody starts from zero, and you have just as much chance of success as someone else, regardless of how many followers you currently have. Your own message and offerings are always going to be different from someone else's because you are a unique person. You have a different style of communication with your marketing. You have different marketing channels with which to reach people. Your branding is different. Your personal energy is different. Your confidence is different. Your desires are different. You have a different mindset. So if you work on being the best version of yourself that you can be in all of these different areas, you will naturally reach the people that you are supposed to reach, and there will be no other brand that can get in the path of your purpose. Therefore, competition doesn't exist. And here's another thing worth pondering. When you are interested in a particular niche, have you ever bought more than one product from more than one brand? Have you ever bought two books on the same subject? Have you ever bought two courses on similar subjects? Have you ever watched two videos, listened to two podcasts, or read two blog posts on a particular subject? Of course you have. We all have, and that's why the other brands in your niche will not stand in your way of success. There is more than enough room for everybody. Here is my new belief number two. Competitors are actually only contributors. After I started seeing other brands in my niche as contributors to the market rather than my own personal competitors, everything changed. The use of the word competitor can be very negative. It turns everything into a battle in which there is always only one winner and many losers. And if you approach business in this mindset of standing a very small chance of being a winner, but a very big chance of being a loser, no wonder you're scared of the competition. When you look at brands as contributors, something changes inside you. You realize that everyone is working towards the same goal and the common good of humanity. You are all contributing towards helping people and providing value for people, and anyone who approaches business with the mindset of helping people and keeping that in the forefront of their mind will always be a winner and will always be rewarded for this. Another big problem with seeing the other brands in your niche as competitors is that it makes you feel like you're in a battle with them, and therefore you're not likely to be on friendly terms with the other brands. When you see all brands as contributors and recognize that you're all going to work for the same common good of humanity, you can actually begin to work together and share each other's work. You can interview each other and you can be affiliates for each other. Online businesses can be very lonely, and it is so much more fun having other people to work with. I used to be a member of a blog network with other health bloggers, and we all helped each other and shared each other's work, and it was one of the most fun times I've ever had in my business. Here's my new belief number three. Contributors can model success and motivate you. Some people get so scared of the competition that they won't even look at the other contributors in the niche. They get so envious when it comes to contact with brands that have what they want that they try and block them out and pretend they don't even exist. They stay in their own little bubble and are not even aware of what the market is doing as a whole. And I have done this myself, and I always ended up coming across the biggest brand that I was trying to avoid and feeling so negative every time it happened. However, you can turn these feelings of envy on their heads and start to see your contributors in a different light. Look at the contributors' success. Let it sink in how well they've done. Now choose to see this as motivation for yourself. Choose to believe that if someone has achieved something, it is also possible for you. If one person can achieve this, anyone can achieve the same thing. You can also use somebody else's success to feel feelings of gratitude. Feel grateful that this kind of success is possible at all. Just a few years ago, it was not even possible for anyone to have success online because the internet didn't exist. Every day we are able to achieve more and more new things, and you can be grateful that other people are paving the way and showing you exactly how they achieved success so you can do the same. The more you can feel gratitude for someone else's success, the more you will convince your own mind that you yourself are successful, as your brain doesn't know the difference between feeling grateful for someone else's success or your own. Another feeling it is good to feel when you notice someone else's success is excitement. Feel excitement that there are a large amount of people who want to engage with your niche. Feel excited that this is a profitable market and that you are lucky enough to be in this niche sharing in this success. That is why it is good to find models of success, people who have gone before you and paved the way for your own success. These people are not to be feared or envied. They are to be thanked for their bravery in showing you what is possible. So here's how to overcome fear of competition. Now I'm going to take you through my stamp it out process to reject disbelief to show you how I overcame my fear of competition. First of all, I identified what the disbelief was. My disbelief was that I had competition that other brands were preventing me from being successful. My disbelief was that I had competition and that other brands were preventing me from being successful. I then analysed the disbelief. The advantages of believing that I had competition and that it was stopping me from being successful was that I didn't need to face the fact that I had lost interest in this particular niche. Another advantage was that I didn't have to take ownership over my success, as it's much easier to blame other people than take responsibility yourself. Then I asked myself what the disadvantages of my disbelief were. For me, the disadvantage was that my business was going downhill. Next, I asked myself if the disbelief was actually true. First of all, I asked myself if this brand was actually competition, and the answer was that this statement was subjective. It was totally my own opinion. Some people would have agreed with this statement and others would have disagreed. Therefore, it's not a fact and it's not true. The second part of this question was asking myself if it was true that another brand had prevented me from being successful. If I had asked other people this question, the majority would have said that no, that most of the time someone else can't stop you from being successful. The very word success is an opinion-based word. It is subjective. We all disagree on what it means to be successful. Therefore, the answer again has to be that no, this is not a true statement. My statement was a lie. It was not the truth, and that's why it is called a disbelief, because it is the refusal to believe in the actual truth. When I realized this statement was a disbelief, I was more than ready to let go of it. What I do to release disbelief is I write the disbelief down on a piece of paper that I call a stamp it out note, and I fold it up into a tiny square. Then I drop it into my stamp box, which is a box that I've allocated specifically for this purpose. I then feel the feeling of relief of letting go of this statement. Now that the disbelief has gone, what is left is empty space, and this feels awkward. The brain needs some kind of belief to fill this empty space, otherwise it won't be convinced that the disbelief has truly gone. I then brainstormed some new beliefs that it would feel good to think instead of the old belief. These new statements are called brain stamps because they stamp your neural pathways in your brain with a new belief that makes you feel successful. Here are some of my new brain stamps. There is no such thing as competition. The right audience for me always finds me no matter what. When I keep focused on helping people, I will always find people to help. My message is more important than my fear. I am so unique that nobody could ever compete with me. I am a contributor, not a competitor. I contribute to the good of humanity along with other like-minded people. When I work alongside other contributors, we all achieve more together and have more fun. I choose to believe that if somebody has achieved something, it is also possible for me. If one person can achieve this, anyone can achieve this same thing. I am so grateful that this kind of success is possible at all. Other people have paved the way for my success and have shown me the path to take. I am so grateful for all of the success that contributors have experienced in my niche. I am so excited that so many people are engaged with my niche. I am so grateful for the bravery of the people who stepped out of their comfort zone to show us what can be achieved. And it's good to read these brain stamps out loud at least once a day for 30 days. Also, try to catch negative thoughts and reframe them as they pop into your mind by releasing the old thought and thinking one of these brain stamps instead. So now that you've seen how valuable it is to go through this process of releasing disbelief, you might be wondering how you can start this process on all of your disbeliefs that are keeping you stuck. And I have created a stamp it out process checklist and workbook to help you work through these questions yourself. This stamp it out process workbook is available as part of the free stamp book bonus bundle for those who purchase my stamp goals book. The reason I added it to the book bonus bundle is because I explain this concept in much greater detail about how to use this process in my stamp goals book, and I also have a checklist that you can print out as part of this workbook. In my book, I show you where you've been going wrong with goal setting, how to transform your business by setting the right type of goals, how to make sure you achieve your goals every time, and how to make a plan for achieving your goals that will lead you to success, and how to make goal achievement a habit. And you can read more about Stamp Goals book by going to kathkyle.com/stamp goals. And while you're waiting for your copy of Stamp Goals book to arrive, you can start taking practical action in your business today. You can watch my free workshop, How to Plan Your Dream Business Six-Figure Business in 30 Days. And in this free workshop, I show you how to plan your dream six-figure business in 30 days that fits your personality, desires, and ideal lifestyle, and make money from a brand new business even if you have no experience or product to sell. And this workshop is valued at $77 and is part of my Dream Business Blueprint course. And I am giving you free access to this workshop and an associated workbook for a limited time. And you can get hold of that by going to kathkyle.com/blueprint. And you are going to be so glad that you did. Next time, I'm sharing how to hustle less and manifest more for easy business success. So make sure you subscribe to my podcast, Manifest Business Success, my YouTube channel, and follow me on Instagram @Kath_Kyle so you don't miss that. And I will also let you know via email when my new piece of content has arrived. And I'm currently giving away 4 brand new free gifts every month to my email subscribers. And you can opt in to any one of my free gifts, such as my free 100 plus success mantras. And here is an example of a couple of my own success mantras. Better on time than perfect. Don't kill the creator who creates the killer content. And you can download my free success mantras by going to kathkyle.com/mantras. And now it's your turn to go and put your stamp on the world.